Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. Today I have with me the new Dacia Sandero Stepway 2021 model with the automatic transmission. And in this video we will make the full review, guys. I will give you the technical data, interior, exterior. We will talk about this car in every single detail. So if you want to find out everything about this new Dacia Sandero Stepway automatic transmission comfort version, stay with me until the end of the video because you will find everything about the car. Also, if you're new on my channel, just click the subscribe button to see all the new videos, all the new notifications that will come on my channel. Also, guys, if you want to see the test drive, I will have a separate video with the same car with automatic transmission. Also, I have one with a manual transmission. So if you want to see that, click the subscribe button to see also the notification when those videos will come out. At least the automatic transmission video will come soon. The manual, it's already on the channel, so check it out. First of all, guys, I want to start by telling you that I'm right here in Switzerland at Garage Galliker. I will leave the link in the description. If you want to buy the car, if you want to test it, if you want to see the car, check them out, guys. The link is in the description. Also, I will give you the price, at least here in Switzerland. Also, the price may be different from country to country, so they are not always the same. Dacia Sandero Stepway Comfort with automatic transmission CVT. It comes with the 1 liter petrol engine. We will talk about that in a second. The price of the car, 50,890 francs is the basis price with all those options right here. I think you can pause the video if you want to read it. And if you add some extra packages, for example, the safety pack, you will have to pay 500 francs extra. If you want to get the metallic color, 550 francs. If you want to get the electric windows on the rear, you will pay 150, and if you want to have a spare tire, you will have to pay 100. I guess here the navigation street map are free, and the final price will be 70,190 francs. Pretty great price for what this car can offer. And I have to tell you guys, I reviewed a few days ago the new Dacia Spring Electric, and now when I'm getting inside this Dacia Sandero Stepway, I feel like it's much better here. I wish the Spring was the same quality as this one, the same size, and I don't know, I think Dacia really improved it in the last years from the previous model at least. Also, before I go to technical data, I want to tell you that the car weight, it's 1,237 kilograms. Also, the consumption, 6.2 liter is the estimated consumption, and 139 CO2 grams emission. Anyway, let's go to the deeper technical data. So as I said, the car come with a 1 liter petrol engine with 3 cylinders in line. Also, the power of the car, 91 horsepower, 142 newton meters. It's a front wheel drive, and it comes with this automatic transmission CVT, 1 speed. So many people waited, and finally, guys, you will see it on my channel, also the test drive. Anyway, the range of the car with a 32 liter fuel tank capacity, it's 650 kilometers. The top speed of the car, 163 kilometers per hour, 0 to 100 in 14.2 seconds. And something that also impressed me is the ground clearance, 20.1 centimeters. It's a great ground clearance. At least you can go a little bit off-road with it, and also you can drive without any problem on bad roads. Now, the car comes with ventilated brake discs in the front, drum brakes on the rear, 16-inch rims, the turning radius of the car, 10.4 meters. Also, the trunk, the boot capacity, 328 liters. If you fold down the seats completely, you will have 1,108 liters. Also, in the front, the car come with independent McPherson coil spring with anti-roll bar suspension. On the rear, we have independent cross-arm coil spring. So those are the technical data, guys. Now let's start the review, and then we will make the conclusion in the end. Actually, guys, because the car doesn't come with all that fancy stuff like folding mirrors and the key, you cannot do so many things with the key. Also, it doesn't come with keyless entrance. I just decide to start the car, to turn on the light directly, and I will show you the key a little bit later. Let's go a little bit around the car, and right here on the right of me, I have this new Dacia Spring. And if some of you was curious about the size, I have to tell you that Dacia Sandero Stepway, it's a little bit bigger than the Spring. The Spring, it's quite small, I should say, a little bit smaller, a little bit more compact. Where if you look at Dacia Sandero Stepway, it's more like a Volkswagen Golf, a little bit bigger with the ground clearance bigger, 20 centimeter ground clearance. It's really good for bed roads. It's perfect. And also I will talk a little bit about these plastic things here that I find it super useful in time. Not only that, the car, it's very affordable, very cheap, but also it will last longer if it has these plastics around the wheels, around the edges of the car, because in this way you will protect the paint, you will protect the paint from rust, from all kind of stuff. So even in the front here, I love the fact that they add this protection here. So if I have to choose from Sandero or Stepway, I will definitely go with Stepway because of those protection plastics around the wheels, around the car, almost everywhere. I like also this color very much. I think it's one of my favorite color on Dacia Sandero. And not only the color, but the front of the car look lovely. Look at the hood, guys. I mean, look at those lines on the hood, how aggressive, how nice they are. In terms of design, I think it looks quite beautiful from the front end. From the side, it's not bad, it's quite beautiful. I mean, they improve a lot from the years, previous years, in my opinion. Yeah, it's a nice car. Even from the back, you can see on this color, you can see the lines a little bit better here in the back. It looks much, much nicer. I don't know about you, but this goldish color fits really well with Sandero. Now, let's go up here on the roof. We have a big antenna, something that I wish was a little bit smaller. And then we have these roof rails where you can see the Stepway letters right here. And also you can add some extra storage on the roof. That's also very useful. And we go here to the roof spoiler in the back. I think here they can improve a little bit to make a little bit more extended, more sporty look. But I guess it's okay. It doesn't have any aspiration to a sporty car, so I guess it's fine. Here's the brake light, the LED light for the brakes. Then you have heated window in the back. Also you have this wiper, pretty useful most of the time. It's really useful when it's raining. Then you have the Sandero logo writing here, and then you have the Dacia logo in the middle. The lights, as you can see, no LED lights. It says Dacia on the side. We have only normal bulb lights, so it's no LED on the rear. Also, the turning signals are simple halogen light, as you can see, even from the back. But the design, it's nice. Maybe in the future they will come also with some kind of LED. Even the fog lamps, if you look down here, it's also a normal halogen light. And on the other side, right here, the same story. Yes, anyway, if you look at the number plate, the lights from the number plate, you can see that we have LED lights. So that's what impressed me. Most of the car doesn't have LED lights on the number plate. They have it on the rear, but this time Sandero and Dacia choose to put LED lights on the number plate. It's nice. Then you have the camera here, reverse camera. It's right there. And then we have six sensors in the back. Why six? Four are used most of the time for parking, and the one from the side here are used for the blind spot technology. And let me go on the side, let me go on the mirror to show you. So you can see that the car come with blind spot technology. You can see right here in the corner. By the way, the mirrors are also big and you have a great visibility on the mirrors. The same color as the car. Also doesn't have the turning signals on the mirrors. The turning signal is here on the body, on the side. And even this light, it's normal bulb light, halogen light, so no LED. Anyway, going forward, here is the tank on the right side. Pretty simple, nothing fancy. Also old school tank entries right there. It's okay. Going down here, you have this sticker. Right here is not a plastic. Keep in mind that this is a sticker, a black sticker right here on the door. I was also thinking for the first time that this is a plastic. That was very nice. At least when you open the door, you hit something. A plastic in this area will be really useful, but it's just a sticker. Around the windows here, we have rubber, black rubber, and also black mat between the windows right here. No camera, it's just some sensors for the raining and lights up there. But you don't have any camera to read the traffic speed limit or stuff like that. Anyway, let's go in the front. The same story in the front. We have six sensors. Those are from the side for the blind spot technology. Those are for the parking. Then I tell you before, I like very much the front of this Dacia Sandero Stepway. Down here you have the fog lamps, normal halogen light, some chrome insertion here. Then you have LED lights, guys, for the low beam. And I think the high beam is normal halogen light, if I remember well. The daylight, it's LED and it looks really nice. And then the turning signals, normal halogen light right there. But it's a big improvement. I think on the next models, we will see only full LED lights. On the down part here, we have some air intakes to cool down the engine. And here you have the radar in the front for emergency brake, adaptive cruise control, and all that safety features. It's great to see it here in this price range. Then the Stepway, nice letters there. Then the Dacia logo, the old logo, some chrome design and the same insertion on the front grille here. Overall, a nice, nice design. Before we go to the rims, guys, I want to tell you that the car come with drum brakes on the rear. You can see the drum brakes here. They are okay. I mean, for the size of the car, for the speed of the car, you don't need brake disc on the rear. Most of the brake, 80% of the brake on all cars are made in front, so on the rear, drum brakes are just fine. Also, this car come with 16-inch rims, as I tell you before, and a lot of gum. I'm really curious, I will start the test drive after this video, and I'm really curious how it's to drive this car, and I see a lot of gum here, so should be really comfortable over the bumps. Those gums so big will help the suspension. Then we have ventilated brake discs in the front. I think you can see it there, and the rims look relatively fine. You have a plastic cap here. I think you can take it out. Behind them, there are some kind of black metal. So keep in mind that those are plastic caps right here. They look nice on the car. And yeah, look at this. Anyway, this is the exterior, guys. I hope I didn't miss something. Let me show you the engine bay, and then we will go in the back in the trunk. All right, guys, so I just opened the trunk here. I want to show you the engine bay so you can make an idea the way it looks. I spare you from the time when I open it up. It comes with an automatic lift gate trunk here in the front. This is the engine, 1 liter petrol engine, 3 cylinders in line, 91 horsepower. Here is the battery, 12 volt battery, fuse box. Then we have the liquid cooling right there, the oil right here, and the wiper liquid, it's right there up. So yeah, this is it, guys. Anyway, let's go in the back, let's go in the trunk. All right, guys, let's go in the trunk right now. You open it from here, pretty simple. I like the fact that this door, it's pretty light. Then you have this protection right here that we will take it out, and I will show you the way it looks without it. But another thing that I like is the fact that you have plenty of space here. Of course, you don't have a flat floor. You have this paint here, no plastic protection right here, so you can scratch this directly, the paint. I don't know if that's matter, but I like the fact that you have a very deep, I think it's 30-35 centimeter deepness here. It's really deep. You have some hooks here almost everywhere in the corners, so you can see also here. Then you have this creek. I'm not sure the name of it. Tell me, guys. I forget. Anyway, you have a normal bolt light, hooks in every corner, hooks in every corner. Also here, you have this triangle and the vest, and under here, of course, because we pay 100 extra francs for the spare tire, it's right here. And relatively huge space, to be honest, here in the trunk, plus extra tires. I mean, for the size of the car, it's just perfect. If you want to take this out, you can take it very easy. It's a little bit complicated for me with one hand, but I can do it just like that. If you want to take it out in 1 second with one hand, this is very light. It's a big trunk. You can fit in here a lot of stuff without any problem. So from this point of view, it's relatively fine. The only downside that I find is that if you want to fold down the seats, you have to fold it 60-40. You cannot fold the middle part. But anyway, it's fine. Then pull this up, push it back, pull this up on the side here, and then push it forward. And this is it, guys. Anyway, this should go a little bit downward because of the headrest, but this is the space here. Practical for the size of the car, practical. It is big, in my opinion. You don't have a flat floor, but it's okay. You have maybe here 10 to 15 centimeter step, but it's okay. relatively fine, in my opinion. If you think at the price, if you think at what the car offer, I think it's more than enough, in my opinion. And yeah, let me go on the other side, open the door here, and you can see the car open the door almost 90 degrees. The opening, it's pretty big. Also, let me put this on the side, the seat belt. I think the seat belt is somewhere. Yeah, stick there, you can put it on the side. You can see the entrance in the car from the size, it's relatively big. I like that. And you can see one more time the way it looks, the trunk. So it's very, very useful in my opinion. Plenty of space here. Also on the legs, you still have some space. Even the transmission tunnel is not so big, and that's a good thing. And overall, yeah, it's relatively fine. Relatively fine. The trunk, the space, here, it's pretty practical. Anyway, let me put everything back, guys, and we will go inside. So here on the doors, we have a big window made by two pieces. So we have a fixed window, and then you have this one right here that you can fold it all the way down. Then keep in mind that all the door, it's made by plastic. The design, it's nice, but it's made by plastic, so that's something to keep in mind. You have the handle in chrome, you have the electric adjustment for the windows, and then you have a big speaker here and some storage space. So overall, the practicality, it's relatively good. Big entrance here from the side, so you can see one more time the way it looks here. In my opinion, pretty much space here. I will go inside and I will show you also the space. I was impressed. I mean, I didn't expect to have so much space behind the front seats. Stuff material, storage spaces here, and if we turn around, we have also the seats made by stuff material. So everything is stuff material, no leather or stuff like that. But I like very much those headrests. They are kind of a memory pillow. When you press it, when you touch it, it feels the same. Then of course it has some trim, some stitches in the same color as the car. And then you have the Isofix for child. You can install two child seats here. And I like that you have side support. They are big enough, wide enough, and also in the middle, it's kind of flat, so you should have a good position even in the middle there. And even because you don't have any armrest or cup holders in the middle, you have also better comfort with your back here in this area. So let me go inside, guys. Let's close the door. Also, I noticed that the sound insulation in the car, it's relatively good. Also on my head here, plenty of space. I will talk a little bit more about the sound insulation when we drive in the test drive video. But overall, look at the head, look at the space, it's crazy. I'm 173 centimeter, and at least for me, it's crazy spacious on my head. And yeah, the comfort is very good. The only thing that I wish was different, it's in this area to have some soft material, kind of, you know, it's only plastic, but I guess it's fine. The visibility is more than perfect. I mean, it's perfect. The way they design it, long like this, I like it. For me, it's perfect. I think for everybody, we'll have a great visibility here in the back. So the knee space, the space on my knees, this is the space, more than enough space. I can stretch my legs without any problem in the under the front seat. So that's a great thing. Here in the middle, you don't have any USB, but you have this 12 volt port, and you have a small transmission. And if I go in the middle, I go very easy in the middle. I can stay somehow also with your legs together. Not so good, but it's fine. This is the space on my knees, plenty of space on my knees as well. And on my head, this is the space, more than enough. Stretch my hand, almost stretch my hand. Even here, almost stretch my hand, but it's relatively fine. In my opinion, it's more than enough space for the size of the car. The way it looks is just great. Anyway, let's go in the front, guys. We will talk about the dashboard, the multimedia, and the things in the front right there. So let's go. So guys, here in the front, one big window from one piece. That means good visibility in the mirror. Here is not like in the back, guys, where we have all plastic. This time here, we have plastic on the upper side, but here in this area where your arm is resting, we have stuff material. So that's better. And also it has a quite interesting trim. Then you have the handle, the same as on the back. Then we have electric button for the windows, electric adjustable mirrors, and also you can lock the windows if you want for kids. And also you have this insertion here with the same color as the car, That looks quite interesting. Then storage space, more than enough storage space. And then you have also the speaker right here. So overall, the door look much better than in the back, and it's quite nice for this price range. Going inside here, guys, I want to show you first of all the seats. The seats in the front look quite nice. I like the way they write Stepway there, the way they design it. It's quite nice, and also they are pretty big, wide, big. You have side support here. I like also those stitches, also some kind of orange insertion, the Stepway logo, of course, tough material, and also the headrest are the same as in the back, the same kind of memory pillow right there. Anyway, going forward, manual adjustable seats, normal pedals, no aluminum pedals. Here you have some fuse box, you have the controller for the lights, you can adjust the position. And if you go a little bit upper, you can see also right here the vents. The vents are nice, also some insertion as the same color, in the same color as the car. They are quite nice when you touch it, the quality is relatively good. Also the same stuff material here, they add it on the dashboard, so you have soft material in this area. I think this is the only soft material that you have it on the dashboard, and you can see it's extend all over in the middle part of the dashboard. On the upper side, although you have plastic everywhere, that's something to keep in mind. Anyway, let me go inside. And go inside the car, close the door. Visibility around the windows, more than perfect. Nothing to say about the visibility. In my opinion, it's very good. Maybe a little bit in the back there, you have a blind spot, but the car comes also with a reverse camera. Here in the middle, you have this armrest that you can also take it up and put it back. It's a stuff material armrest, and also it feels quite the same as it feels on this headrest, the same kind of memory pillow. Then you have some storage space, two cup holders, manual handbrake. Keep in mind, it comes with a manual handbrake. I wish, although, with this automatic transmission to be combined with some kind of electronic handbrake, but I guess it's fine. Then going forward, you can see the gear shifter for kind of the stick for the position, and you can change the different driving modes. For example, parking, reverse, neutral, drive. And this L here, it's some kind of sport mode, so when you are in drive, you can put it in L and the engine will go to a higher RPM, so it will give you kind of a sporty mode. Here you have some storage space, then you have a 12 volt port, an USB port, very useful. And then you have manual climatic system. We have it on this Stepway. I love the automatic climatic system from Dacia, but I guess it's okay also with the manual one. Going a little bit upper, lock and unlock, blinker button, start stop engine, and eco mode. Eco mode, I will explain you in the test drive video. It's kind of eco mode. You have kind of normal mode and eco mode. In eco mode, of course, the acceleration is slower and it gives you better economy. And here you have a huge glove box. I love the glove box, I tell you, it's really big. The glove box, it's good in my opinion. Now, going forward, you have another USB port here, close to multimedia system. This USB, it's also for your phone, and it's also made, for example, if you don't have this navigation, you can install your phone and you can charge your phone and stuff like that. Anyway, it was much more useful in the previous Dacia cars. Nowadays, when you have on this multimedia system also the possibility to connect it to Android Auto and Apple CarPlay wireless, it doesn't seem to have so much importance right now, this USB. It was also okay if it was down here. So yeah, overall it's fine. The vents here in the middle, the same design as up there. Here, guys, on this area we have a mirror where you can see yourself quite good. And then you have a microphone, SOS button, and then you have lights. Those lights are normal bulb light. Keep in mind, yeah, let me actually to put the contact to show you. Look at this, normal bulb light, guys. And then the mirror, great visibility in the mirror. I mean, love the mirror. You have perfect visibility, you can see right there in the back. Let's start the engine for a while. And let me show you the cockpit. The cockpit, it's the classic analogical cockpit, nothing fancy, nothing crazy there. You can see also a few things like pressure, tire pressure, the temperature, the speed, and stuff like that. So it's nothing crazy, so don't expect to see something crazy. You can see also the average consumption right here. That was until now, how much range you have, how much distance you drive. So I guess in the last 800 kilometers, you have a 7.9 liter consumption. Yeah, it's pretty good for a new car. Anyway, this is the cockpit. Then going a little bit down to the steering wheel. The steering wheel is the same steering wheel as you find it almost on the all new Dacia, except the Dacia Spring. Where the quality is not so good as this one. You have this steering wheel, it's made by leather, so the quality is very good, and also the grip, it's great. I love the grip of it. It feels quite nice as you touch it, and also it's very light. We will talk about that in the test drive. Here you have the cruise control settings, where you can set and activate the cruise control. You can see it on the screen right there as we drive the limiter, and also the cruise control is down here, so you can set from here the speed. It's super simple to use, and I like the fact that the buttons are very easy adjustable. Behind the steering wheel, you can see right there is the controller for the music and sound system and stuff like that. Yeah, anyway, this is it, guys. Going forward, let's talk a little bit about the multimedia system. Multimedia system, I have a separate video about it. I have a separate video how to connect your Android phone to this multimedia system through wireless, and I explain you there everything about it, but I will go a little bit fast through it. Here you have the home button, here you have the settings button, you have the radio, you have the media right here where you can connect your music and your phone and your things and your USB. Then you have the phone here where you can connect your Bluetooth, the vehicle, here are the information in the settings, active brake, blind spot, you can activate, deactivate from here, the door locking, the parking assists things, and then you have the driving echo, where it gives you a few tips about how to drive economical. For example, you can see here the last consumption as well, and then you have the eco coaching here. Actually, it kind of teach you, it gives you some tips about how to drive more economical, if to save more energy. Then you have the navigation, of course, that you see it also in the other video. Navigation, it's fine. You can use this navigation from Dacia, or you can use the navigation from Android phone or Apple phone. It's much more convenient and much more easy, to be honest. And if you press a destination, you just press OK, and then calculate, and then you press OK one more time, and it's calculated directly there. So it's fine. It's fine. Also, this navigation, it's relatively good, so I can't complain about it. Also, you can cancel the route, very simple. You go back to home. Smartphone integration here. I don't want to go too much into detail, but I have a separate video where I show you how to connect it. Then you have the audio settings, display settings, device settings, and system settings, where you can change the language and all other things. It's very simple navigation system, very simple multimedia, very practical in my opinion. Anyway, let me stop the engine and let's end up this video, guys. So guys, that was the review with the new Dacia Sandero Stepway with automatic transmission. Also, the test drive video will come soon, and if you want to see it, check it out on my channel, guys. We'll come next days on the channel. If it's not already there, just subscribe to the channel to see the notification when that video will come out. Also, guys, I want to give it the rating for this Dacia Sandero Stepway automatic transmission. If I think about price and what this Sandero offer, I will give it a 9.7. I'm compare it only the price, the offer, and what it is, the car, you know. So I know guys, I have a lot of comments from you, but I just compare it. I think about what can offer, what is the price of it, and then I give it the rating. Anyway, that's it, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you get some useful information from it. If you like it, please like it, share it. Also, subscribe to the channel to see the newest cars that will come on my channel. Also, I will leave the link in the description to Galliker Garage if you want to buy it, if you want to test drive, if you want to see it. Tell them you see my video, you want a discount, they will give you a nice discount. Also, thank you very much for watching my video. I really appreciate that. Thank you to all of you guys. I really appreciate. Also, don't forget to check out our website, sda-car.com. There you find a lot of information about cars, videos, tips about how to buy a car, a new car, secondhand car, and stuff like that. And anyway, that was the video, guys. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, and I guess I see you soon in the next one. Bye, guys.